Oh, what's up? Morning, everybody. It is 32 degrees outside and raining and kind of icy too. So it's the perfect mix of miserable outside. But anyway, so today I wanted to make a quick video about anxiety. That's a thing a lot of people struggle with, and I used to struggle with it to a crippling degree, you could say. I mean, it was so, it's kind of funny looking back on it, because it was like my daily thought processes were so all over the place. I mean, I'd be worrying about things that didn't even make sense. I'd be worrying about the immediate day, what I was going to eat, what was going to happen 5 years from now, what was going to happen 10 years from now, what was going to happen if this didn't happen. You know, I would just create hypothetical after hypothetical of things that could possibly go wrong, you know what I mean? And then how I would handle it and all this other nonsense, right? And I look back on it and I just kind of laugh, because I'm like, man, that was a lot of wasted energy and stuff, right? And it was a big problem. I mean, I spent 8 years going to the doctor and telling them about it and getting prescription drugs and doing it the old traditional way that everybody kind of knows and loves or whatever. And, you know, I have to laugh because, like, I always deep down just was doing this, doctor's orders, right? But I never really got better, right? And every time I talked to a doctor, I mean, it was like we weren't ever talking about root cause, you know? It was always just like, well, take this and you'll feel better, take this and you'll feel better. And I was just like, okay, I do this, I feel better, but then what happens when it stops working as good? I just take more of this and I feel better, and then I take more, and then, I mean, what's the end game here, you know? Oh, there's nothing you can do, you're just going to be anxiety-y for the rest of your life. Good term, I know. And it made me skeptical, I guess you could say. I was super skeptical of that line of thought. So one day when I, you know, came across the program, I actually came across it for other reasons or whatever, but I did start to look into the whole copper toxicity and how that can kind of cause you racing thoughts. And I read that article and I was like, holy crap, that's spot on. That sounds just like my anxiety or whatever, right? I've been going to doctors for 8 years and nobody's ever said anything like that. So what is this thing? So, you know, I jumped in and I started to do it. And, you know, it was about a year into the program, I had a hair test and I had a huge copper dump on that bad boy. And I was like, wow, like it was that period in time that coincided with that copper dump where I noticed that my anxiety levels decreased like tenfold. I mean, like 100-fold, you know what I mean? Mind-bogglingly so. I mean, I swear, it's like one day I just kind of woke up and it was like I was in a dream or something, and now I'm like a new kind of person. You know, I haven't really been able to really figure it out since then, but I'm telling you, once I had that copper dump, my brain like changed completely. So I mean, it's quite the feat, if I had to be honest. So, you know, and I also say to a lot of people out there that are just skeptical, and don't get me wrong, like I am a skeptic. I mean, I'm probably arguably a bigger skeptic than most people, to the fact that when I came across this program, I was reading about all the magical and wonderful things that it healed, and every ailment this and this problem this, and I was like, what is this thing, like some sort of silver bullet? Like, I was like, no way. I didn't really believe it. So I actually jumped on board initially as more of an experiment. I was like, okay, I'm gonna try this thing, you know, I'll just try it. You know, I'm one of those people that, like, I'm skeptical enough to give something a try, you know? If you're just so skeptical where you're like, no, I can't even, I'd argue that you're just a filthy casual when it comes to skepticism. You need to amp your skepticism game up a little bit, but I digress. So I jumped on the program and I did it for 3 months, and I noticed right away, I mean, I started feeling a whole lot better right out the gate. But then I was researching it more and more, and I was like, holy crap, this thing's like a lifestyle. I gotta do this every day. And that's when I didn't really want to do it anymore, because it was like too much work or whatever. So like the next 7 months after the initial burst, I literally spent 7 months trying to debunk the program, okay? Like, I was trying not to do it. So I spent so much time doing it to see if it worked, to see if I didn't have to do it. But by God, it just kept working. So if you're a skeptic or whatever, you know, I would argue this to a lot of my friends, because a lot of my friends are and stuff too. I'm like, well, number one, you need to step your skepticism up. Number two, try it for 90 days. I mean, try it for 90 days and see what happens. I guarantee if you do the program at 90%+ for 90 days, you'll know if it's for you or not. And what do you have to lose? I mean, all it really is taking good care of yourself.